they call the Sunshine State, with better news. But it would be very unwise to deny that the situation indeed is very gloomy. And it might take a while for you to understand the situation that we are in now. Maybe you as Americans still think that Europe is a place with a great culture and a profound way of looking at things. Maybe you see immigration as something that is inherently good for a country, as it contributed so much for the United States, and I understand that. But ladies and gentlemen, the Europe, as you know it, from the visiting Europe or from stories from your parents or friends or whoever, is on the verge of collapsing. We are now witnessing profound changes that will forever alter Europe's destiny and might send the continent in what Ronald Reagan once called a thousand years of darkness. And the takeover of Europe that is currently taking place is part of a global fight of Islam for world domination. And let me tell you first that Islam is not a religion. Islam is a totalitarian political ideology. Islam's heart lies at the Quran. And the Quran is a book that calls for hatred, that calls for violence, for murder, for terrorism, for war and submission. The Quran calls upon Muslims to kill kafirs, non-Muslims. The Quran describes Jews as monkeys and pigs. And Churchill, and I agree with him, Churchill compared the Quran in the book in the 50s to Adolf Hitler's Mein Kampf. Ladies and gentlemen, the core of the problem with Islam is twofold. First, the commands of the Quran are not limited by place or time. They apply for all time to all Muslims of the world. And second, the Quran is Allah's personal word that leaves no room for interpretation. Therefore, there is not such a thing as a moderate Islam. Of course, there are many moderate Muslims, but a moderate Islam does not exist. As the Turkish Prime Minister, Mr. Erdogan, once rightfully said, he said, there is no moderate Islam, Islam is Islam. And apart from the Quran, the life of the Prophet Muhammad is very important for you to understand, in order to understand this terrible ideology. Muhammad plays a crucial part in this Islamic totalitarian ideology. Muhammad, in fact, is the role model for all Muslims in the world. But who was Muhammad? Muhammad, in fact, was a pedophile, was a conqueror, was a warlord. And in establishing Islam, he preached violence and the slaughter of non-Muslims. He took part in 78 battles and slaughtered the Jewish tribe of Bana Qurayza. And Muhammad once said, and I quote, "I have been ordered by Allah to fight against people until they testify that there is no God but Allah and that Muhammad is his messenger." And indeed, Muhammad's behavior inspired Iran's former leader, the Ayatollah Khomeini, to say, and I quote Khomeini, the purest joy in Islam is to kill and to be killed for Allah. And Muhammad's behavior and the Quran inspired jihadists all over the world to slaughter innocent people, like they did in Washington, in New York, in Madrid, in London, and in Mumbai. Ladies and gentlemen, Islam has always attempted to conquer Europe, and it has done so for centuries. The Christian city of Constantinople fell in the 15th century, and now in the 21st century, Islam is trying again, but this time not with armies, but through the application of Al-Hayra, the Islamic doctrine of migration, as expounded so masterfully by my good friend Sam Solomon in his book Al-Hijra, the doctrine that is based on the example of Muhammad, who himself migrated from Mecca to Medina. Ladies and gentlemen, the Libyan leader, Muhammad Gaddafi, said, and also he unfortunately is very correct, and I quote, "We have 50 million Muslims in Europe, and there are signs that Allah will grant Islam victory in Europe, without swords, without guns, without conquest. The 50 million Muslims of Europe will turn Europe into a Muslim continent within a few decades." End of quote. And ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, Gaddafi is right. The Al-Hijra doctrine is and has been very successful in Europe. For the first time in world history, there are dozens of millions of Muslims living far outside the Dar al-Islam, the Islamic world. And that poses enormous problems to the West. Ladies and gentlemen, Al-Hijra may be the end of the Western civilization as we know it. For Islam is not coming to our societies to integrate or to assimilate, but wants to dominate and wants to submit us all. And the most dramatic situation is the one in Europe today. My country is in the process of becoming Hollandistan, as Europe is becoming in the process of becoming Eurabia. And only 12% of the German Muslims see themselves more German than Muslims. And churches throughout Europe are emptying out, whereas mosques are shooting up like mushrooms. Medieval phenomena such as burqas, honor killings, female genital mutilations are becoming more and more prevalent. Sharia testaments, Sharia mortgages, Sharia schools, Sharia banks, Sharia courts, and even Sharia Barbie dolls. Europe has them all today. And I have not even mentioned the fact that, for instance, 70% of all crimes in a European city like Copenhagen are committed by Muslims. Indeed, we let in the Trojan horse. And the free world is now facing a stealth jihad. The Islamic attempt to introduce Sharia law hit by hit. Allow me to give you a few examples also of the Islamization here in the United States. Muslim taxi drivers in Minneapolis have refused over 5,000 passengers because they were carrying alcohol. Muslim students are demanding separate campus housing. Muslim women are demanding separate hours in gyms and swimming pools. Schools in your country are already banning Halloween and Christmas celebrations. Indeed, schools are taking pork off their cafeteria menus to avoid Muslim students. Ladies and gentlemen, be aware that this is only the beginning. If things continue like this, you will have the same problems as we are facing in Europe today. And if we do not stop the process of Islamization, I am sure that we will lose everything. We will lose our identity. We will lose our culture. We will lose our democratic constitutions. We will lose our freedom. We will lose our civilization. In Europe, we are already losing the fight for freedom of speech. We are losing the fight to criticize Islam. And I think that criticizing religions and ideologies always, always ought to be possible in a free world. Human rights exist for the protection of individuals, not religions, and certainly not ideologies. So I propose that all the hate speech laws in Europe are to be repealed. Europe ought to defend the freedom of speech